morning, guys, gals, and non-binary pals. It's Thursday morning. I was actually about to jump on here and say I haven't had chest pain whatsoever today, and I've been up for several hours because my son decided to wake up at 6. And so we've been up since 6. It's 9:30, almost 10 o'clock now. But literally the moment I turned the camera on, my chest started to hurt. So that's very interesting. I kind of decided when I woke up that I would just kind of pay attention to my body and to, like, the things around me, right? Like, for example, right now, where I've been feeling fine all day, I've been hanging out with my son watching TV. I, you know, planned my day out, the things that I plan to get done today while I wait to hear from cardiology or whatever. I made both breakfast, I ate, and throughout all of this, I actually went through my text messages as well because I thought, what if there was something in particular that happened 2 Fridays ago? Maybe somebody sent me an upsetting text message that I didn't quite, like, commit to memory, but it was enough to kind of trigger my anxiety, etc. So I was doing all of these things, and all the while thinking, is that the beginning of chest pain? Is that the beginning of an anxiety attack? And no. So even, like, purposely, or not purposely, but, like, intentionally seeking it out, for lack of a better word, it hasn't happened. And yet right now I sat down, I turned on the camera, and chest pain. All right. So I will continue to monitor myself and my surroundings to see if there's any sort of pattern or anything, but that's definitely very interesting. So speaking of interesting and completely unrelated, last night my husband and I started watching Inventing Anna on Netflix. I've been looking forward to this series for literally months because I'm fascinated by the Anna Delvey Sorokin, whatever her actual name is, case. And so I was really excited to see that the show was finally on. And my husband and I have a bunch of shows that we watch together, but most of them are on hiatus right now. Like, they either just finished or they're coming back soon or whatever. So he was like, we don't have anything to watch, do we? And I told him there's a new episode of Pam and Tommy, and he's like, please don't bring up that show. I will never watch that show. Which is fine, because I've been watching it by myself, and that means I can watch it whenever I want. So I suggested, like, this show sounds really interesting, and I've been looking forward to watching it. You want to watch with me? And we saw 2 episodes last night. We actually started the second one because he said, hey, you want to see another one? So that's good. He's into it. But now it sucks because I really, really want to watch the next one, and I can't. I have to wait for him to get home. So I was looking on Hulu last night while I was waiting for my son to fall asleep, and I realized that they have Australia's Next Top Model, like, all of the seasons. And that's so freaking exciting for me. I'd always been obsessed with America's Next Top Model until I discovered Canada's Next Top Model, which I can't find anywhere, Britain's Next Top Model, Australia's Next Top Model. I even tried watching China's Next Top Model, but that was really hard to follow. Brazil's Next Top Model. All of these shows, obviously, I mean, they had their bits of drama injected here and there, but all of the international shows seemed to take the actual modeling and photography aspect of it way more seriously than the American version, which was just like the Tyra show. Not the actual Tyra show. That's an actual show that existed. You know what I mean? It was just like, hey, look at me, look at me, look at me. Oh, and there's other girls here too, but look at me, look at me. The international versions are far, far, far superior. So I started watching Australia's Next Top Model again from the beginning, and I'm so, 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 so excited about that. But anyway, it's Thursday. It should be hell day, but I'm here just waiting by the phone to see if cardiology will see me. I got those new meds last night, but I haven't started taking them yet. I'm thinking I might take one tonight, just to see how I feel, because my doctor did tell me the very first one, don't take it at bedtime because you don't know when it's, or you don't know how long it's gonna take to like hit you, I guess. So maybe take it a little earlier in the evening so that you can gauge how long it takes to take effect. And how do you feel? Is it a situation where you feel like you need to lay down right away? Is it a situation where like it makes you dizzy or groggy? Like, these are things you need to know so that you can kind of adjust then. When should I take it? I need to be prepared so that if I do start to feel groggy right away, I know that I can go to bed right away and so on. So I'm gonna have to like tag hubby in and let him handle bedtime tonight. Should be easy, because like I said, kiddo's been up since 6, so I'm sure that he'll be tired and he'll be ready for an early bedtime. But yeah, that's what's going on right now. I don't feel anywhere near as short of breath today when I talk, which is fantastic. Like, I'm telling you, I woke up, in spite of waking up so early, I woke up feeling so much better today that I almost feel normal, except for literally when I sat down and first started the camera, I got a chest pain. Which now I feel like the residual pain just kind of fleeting. It's like, it's going away. But the shortness of breath is way less. Like, barely noticeable. Compared to how it's been the last couple of weeks. Even compared to how it was yesterday. So I'm hopeful that... obviously it's not been 100% confirmed yet. But the consensus generally seems to be, from all the medical professionals I've seen in the last week or so, that what's wrong with me is just anxiety. And I say that facetiously because obviously anxiety is a literal killer. But knowing that it's anxiety kind of helps me, you know, like, okay, I know what I'm battling now. Kind of like... man up for, I hate saying that because that's so ridiculous, but it just gives me, it helps me prepare, right? It gives me something to like work towards. Like, if it's my heart, there's only so much I can do about that right now. Whereas if it's my anxiety, then it's like, okay, drink more water, rest, try to avoid obvious triggers. I can't 100% avoid it because it's something in me, it's something internal, but I can do my best, right? So I might even, depending on how the rest of the day goes today, I might try a very short and very like beginner, I guess, like yoga flow, see if that helps out some. I've been avoiding exercise completely for the last couple of weeks because I've been scared to trigger an anxiety attack, or not anxiety, like an asthma attack or something, or even something to do with my heart. But if it is completely stress related, yoga helps. And I know that because it has always. So whatever, I've already talked a lot considering this is just the very first shot in a 4-day long vlog. So I will wrap it up for now. Happy Thursday. I mean, it's not funny because someone literally died, but that was so bad. They legit just said a woman died, the baby is okay, and then the news anchors come out and say it's a miracle, oh my gosh, no one died except for that lady, and then they just go to commercial. Like, they didn't just completely trip over their tongues like that. Happy Friday, friends. Same old, same old. I'm not feeling awful, but I'm definitely still feeling tightness in my chest. I'm feeling breathless when I talk. This just appears to be like the new state of things, and I refuse to accept or manifest that, but it's also pretty clear. I received a call this morning from the network. My primary and my endo and my gyno and a few other specialists that I've had to see along the way are all part of one of the hospitals like networks. I went to a separate hospital. There's a bunch of different like mega hospitals, I guess, down here. And that's why we had to wait for the transfer of records, because I went to hospital A instead of hospital B, where all of my specialists are. Problem is that hospital B's ER was like 40 minutes away. Anyway, take a breath. Forgive me if I have to do that a few more times. I'm feeling actually like a little extra breathless today for some reason. The pain is the same as it's been, or the discomfort, whatever we're calling it. But I am feeling extra breathless today when I talk. Whoa, there's a giant iguana. I'm not even gonna show, there's two of them. I'm not even gonna show you guys because they're so well blended. I'm gonna show you guys. I'm trying anyways through the dirty window and the fact that they're very well camouflaged. I didn't even realize there was two of them until, you know, I did. But you see that branch? There's one and there's two. And they're just hanging out looking at each other. That's so cute. And they're like huge. That's a very sturdy branch. Okay, that obviously very much distracted me. What was I saying? Right, so I got a call from Hospital B, right, which is where all of my doctors are. And they were reaching out to go ahead and schedule cardiology, which is good, right? That's what I wanted. But they gave me two options. They said, I can either do a telehealth appointment with somebody in West Palm Beach, which is like an hour and a half from here with traffic, etc. And the thing about that is that they can see me at the end of next week. That's the earliest I could hope for, is a week from today, through telehealth. But when they call me in to do a stress test, an echocardiogram, all the things that they're gonna want to do to make sure that my heart's okay. Hey, Papa. I might have to go do that at West Palm. So that's not like 100% that that's what's gonna happen, but it's a big possibility that he's gonna wanna see me in his own office. The alternative is I could see somebody in Miami about 30, 40 minutes away, but I'd have to wait until July. And that obviously was not gonna work. So I went ahead and I took the telehealth. Like I said, it's exactly a week today from today. It's Friday morning, telehealth, and not much is gonna happen that day except, you know, we're going to meet officially. Hi doctor, I'm Desiree, nice to see you. I'm gonna fill him in on what happened. He will already have access to all the records from the hospital because it's the same network as my primary. And which I really like. I like having everybody in the same network for exactly that reason, because whatever the primary said, the specialist already has access to. And if the primary put in a note for my gyno, I can't imagine why, but you know what I mean? Like whatever specialist needs to see my primary's notes or another specialist's notes or whatever, they all have access to the same system, which is extremely convenient. So he's gonna have access to all of that, but he's gonna wanna talk to me and like, how am I feeling now? I'm hopeful that a week from now I'll feel better, but who knows really? And I guess from there he'll decide. We need to do a stress test, we need to do an echo, and who knows what else. And then we'll schedule that. And Lord knows how long that's gonna take. But again, everything is a process. We're in America. I'm lucky that I am able to even access a doctor. Healthcare is a privilege in this country. It is not a right, and that's just the matter of fact. And so, yeah. I always have the option of going back to the emergency room, right? So, filled you guys in thus far as that's concerned. For today, though, had the day off. So, I'm gonna film my planner video in a minute and edit a video that I'm hoping to put out tomorrow. And what else? Do some budgeting, like I'm gonna budget out March now, things like that, administrative things, you know? So I'm gonna stick to that today because the house is pretty much clean. I've spent the whole week just cleaning it up and down to pass the time. So there's nothing really much to do there. Yeah. Happy Friday.
So we're outside. Somebody's AC is apparently working really, really hard because it's loud out here. But there were a couple people that commented and asked for an update on the snake plant that my kiddo was not gentle with. So you can see it's like really bruised up and shriveled and just not doing great here. I just stuck the there's so many gnats out here. Jeez, I just stuck the leaf in the soil and I'm still watering it. On the off chance it might sprout roots and like recuperate somehow, I don't know, but I don't have high hopes for that. This right here though, this is still rooted. This is where that came from, and it's got all of this situation here. This is brand new growth. This is gonna become a new leaf. This is obviously a leaf. And so this, I'm confident, will recover. It's gonna take a long time before it's like a plant again, you know? But this poor thing, I'm giving it a fighting chance as much as I can, but I really don't think it's gonna work out. And speaking of the kiddo, my poor baby, earlier in the day, he brought me his talker and he was trying to spell a word, but I could tell that it was a word that he wasn't sure how to spell. And that's always complicated because he's trying to tell me what he wants. I can't assume, or, you know, I can't guess. He has to tell me. And so how am I supposed to help him spell a word when I don't know what the word is that he's trying to say? So I was throwing words at him, none of them were right, and he kind of just ended up giving up and walking away. And a little bit later, he brought me the talker again, and he went into the action words, and he went into the D folder, which was the same letter he was using to spell the word earlier. He was spelling like D-I-Y-G-I-G-Y-Y, like just a jumble of stuff. So he goes into the action folder, and it's things in there like divorce, dive, like they're words that we don't really use. So if I was thinking, okay, I know he's trying, freaking camera shadow. I know he's trying, but I don't think he's not in the right place because he's looking around, he's scanning all the buttons and none of them are the word he wants. So again, he gave up and walked away. And I'm thinking on it and I went, is he trying to spell Disney? So I found a video online where somebody's just walking through the Magic Kingdom for an hour. In 4K, and they're not speaking or anything. It's just them walking through the park, showing everything, getting on rides and stuff. He's been sitting for like 20 minutes now, just watching the video. Maybe just a coincidence. Maybe he loves Disney, so why not? Maybe he saw it and he's like, hey, this sounds great, I'll watch this. Or maybe he's been trying all day to say Disney to me, and I finally like got it. I'll never know, but he's very entertained right now, and I'm really, really wishing that I could take him because I know he must miss it so much. So yeah, just wanted to throw that out there because it just makes me proud to see him like wanting to communicate and really trying to find the ways to do it. Yeah, my kid's just awesome. I'm actually gonna link the video and the channel below because this guy's done such a great job of giving you that theme park experience. This is 4K WDW, and he apparently has videos for all of the different parks, daytime, nighttime, like whatever Disney World experience you want, this guy has a video for it. So I'm very impressed, and we're very much enjoying this. Hey friends, happy Saturday. Happy to report, well, not so happy to report that I've been up since 5:30, not my choice. But I am happy to report that I haven't had any chest pain at all today so far. It's just past noon. And I'm only just now starting to feel short of breath because I'm talking to you. I don't think it's weird because I feel like for the most part I haven't been short of breath when I've been talking today. And I've talked plenty with my husband. But I haven't noticed, I guess. So either it hasn't been happening or I'm just so used to it at this point that it's no longer registering. People fishing at the lake. Oh my god, it's the little kids and their dad. That's cute. Don't look at your phone. Look at your kids. Okay, I'm judging now. I'm gonna stop. But yeah, it's Saturday, so I'm gonna do lots of laundry. I'm gonna do some editing. I'm gonna edit my planner video so it's ready to go. I'm gonna try to do some baking, and just gonna hang out and enjoy the weekend because on Monday, back to work. Happy Saturday.
lots of babies.
Hey friends, happy Sunday. It's Sunday afternoon, I guess. It's like 1 o'clock maybe. And I've been doing some baking, some tidying up around the house. We've been watching Space Force. My husband saw season one whenever it came out, but I never watched it. And season two is out apparently, so he was like, you have to watch this show because it's really, really good. I'll wait to watch season two until you're caught up. So he's rewatching it with me. And we still haven't finished Inventing Anna, but we've got like 3 episodes left. Really, really good too. So happy to report, I haven't had a single chest pain today. I'm only slightly out of breath now when I talk. And so far so good. I haven't taken the anxiety medication yet. Today's the day. There's been stuff going on that has prevented me one way or the other from taking it thus far, until I realized like, oh, I should take it. Wait, it's too late, because the doctor did say, mostly for me than anything, just because she knows how I am and she knows that I'm gonna want to know what to expect, etc. She did say the first time you take it, make sure you take it well before bed so that you can tell how you feel on it, so you can tell how long it's going to take to like start working and so on. And that way you can use that information to plan in the future what time of night is a good time to take it so that you are ready for bed at the same time that the pill is. But like, for example, yesterday I was up since 5:30. Didn't make sense to take it because I was already exhausted. And so it might take effect faster than it typically is supposed to because I was so tired. So I said, no, this is not a good control for a scientific experiment. And then the night before, like, I wanted to stay up late, etc., etc. So tonight is the night. But yeah, so I'm just trying to like do some last minute like admin things around the house, managing household things, so that we're ready to get back to our situation tomorrow. It's gonna be a weird day tomorrow because hubby's off work and our first therapy is not happening because they're closed, but our other two appointments are still happening even though daddy's gonna be here, because those centers are open even though it's President's Day. So after having a whole week off, kiddo's gonna be like, what the heck, but daddy is still here, surely it is still weekend. And he's gonna refuse to accept what he sees on his visual schedule, and he's probably gonna fight me all the while. But he does surprise me every once in a while and kind of behave in a way where it's like, okay, work sucks, because it just does, like, generally, but I've missed the routine, and so I will in fact participate, thank you very much. So I'm hoping for one of those kind of days and not just rawr, I don't wanna get away from me, I don't wanna learn type thing. Either way is just as likely. So that's what's going on. I'm gonna finish baking now, do a couple other little things, and maybe just get to sit down and relax and finish watching one of our shows. Happy Sunday. Alright friends, me and my noisy fan are gonna go ahead and wrap the video up, as it is Sunday night. I was just about to take that anxiety med, but I'm about to jump in the shower, and the warning label says this could make you sleepy, it could make you dizzy, it could make you faint. I'm only taking a half a pill as prescribed by my doctor. She said take half to a whole one, but start with half and see how you feel. And also, I'm a bigger girl, but I definitely do not need to be getting dizzy and fainting in the shower, right? I think we can all agree on that. I'm gonna take it right after. I guess in the next episode, I'll report back and let you all know how that goes. But yeah, tomorrow we're back on the grind. I'm gonna see the cardio, I am gonna see them. It's a telehealth, but I'm gonna see them on Friday and go from there. But honestly, if today is any indication, I'm feeling good. It's almost like the moment that I talked to my primary and she said this is anxiety. Granted, she's not the first to tell me that. I was sure of it too, etc., etc. But it's like, I'm sorry, I'm having a hard time with Instagram. I'm trying to upload my daily video story and it's not, it's giving me errors. Anyways, distraction. The moment she said to me, I know you, I know your history, and I'm positive this is just anxiety, it's almost like that gave my brain permission to be like, you see, it's just anxiety. And if it's not, we're gonna see the cardio soon. Like, everything's falling into place. Don't worry, you're gonna be fine. And it's like, little by little, since I talked to her, I've been feeling a little better, a little better, a little better each day. And except for a slight shortness of breath now while I'm talking to you guys right now, like, I've been fine all day. So that's good, right? It's always nice to end on a happy note. It's always nice to feel like you're on an upswing. And so I'm just trying to hold on to that energy because I'm feeling okay. But also, I'm gonna take the support that I can get where I can get it. And if she agrees, or if she thinks, not agrees because I'm the one that had to come to agree to it, but if she thinks that this might help me overall, you know, better sleep equals less anxiety, and so it's worth a try. And if I hate it, then I'll just never take it again, but it's worth a try. So I will leave you guys with that. I hope you've had a great weekend. Let me know how your week is shaping up so far, and we will talk again very, very soon. I want to thank you so much for watching this video. I really hope that you enjoyed it, and if you did, I hope that you will please give it a big thumbs up. I'd also love it if you would subscribe and click that notification bell, because I post at least 3 times a week and I wouldn't want you to miss a minute. Thanks so much again for watching. Bye!